Good evening, all the healthy people or who wanna be healthy. One of the really hot topics on discussion, especially lately, how you can boost your immune system or take care of it. So I try to share with you more tips if possible, I guess. So if I said like someone will be 1, 2, 3 what most important or what less important, it doesn't make any sense. It's same for keep ourselves alive. You need to oxygen, water, food, and so on. If you skip some of it, basically it's not really possible for keep your body alive. So basically with immune system, it like all in general what you need to keep it for, make it works well for you, and after that you will should not worry about any disease or seasonal flu or whatever else. So okay, let's start step by step. So the first one, so probably environment, but I know who stay in a big cities and a lot of pollutions from factory around, it's not really easy, but environment, it's really really important. So if you can stay in some really nice place, like in the countryside, like this one for example, it's just great. So probably you know, like people who stay in the mountains or in the nature, countryside, usually they in a better health and in a better mood, live longer and so on. Like in the mountains, people like live after 100 years, it's like pretty normal to them. Like in the big cities and high level of stress, it's really rare. And then nutrition is really really important. Nutrition, you have a lot of videos I made already, how to balance your nutrition, what do you need, because if you have not enough vitamin, bam, skin problem, whatever. If you have not enough raw food, your memory get worse and so on. So basically it's common sense. So eat healthy food, not like junk food or overload yourselves with all of the preservatives and so on. What you need to get rid of, and your liver works really hard on it, and etc. So yeah, good nutritions. I will be really really short for not make video too long, so if you need more information about nutrition, you can find it a lot of online and even on my channel as well. Then activity, what's really really important is be active. So it not mean like training hard, at least just go for walk in a park or in a forest, or just have a little bit run or cycling, just do like normal cardio at least 1 hour a day. People who work distantly on a computer with the papers, I don't know, not really active movements and so on. So you need give some boost for your heart, just spread your blood around, load yourself with the oxygen and so on. So basically like activity is really really important. Just do something what you really like, badminton, tennis, whatever, just keep active. I think it's really really important instead of staying home doing nothing. Yeah, who learned the psychology knows like our immune system works well when you go and visit different places, and some places what looks too dirty and dangerous. So your subconscious mind become more aware and boost your immune system, work harder, because oh, it's dirty, it might be dangerous and so on, need work harder. Also, not many people know like all of the things when we communicate with other people, when we touch each other, just shake hands and so on, and all of this tactile senses is boost your immune system as well. It's like okay, you need to be aware in this environment and so on, it should be stronger as well. And let's discuss some like more, let's say, ways. Not I wouldn't say extreme, but if you like feel you get sick already or need to do something, yeah. But if you feel sick, you feel pain, it means too ready. You done something wrong and you need to do something with that. Fasting like make your immune system like really really aggressive, especially if you do fasting like a few days. So in 1 day it will be like more sensitive, more aware, so your naked seed getting bigger, and try to find everything around what can destroy it, like viruses. So basically they take these machines and put them apart and so on. So you can do like unload day by Soviet Union system, old one. So 1 day per week you cannot eat, just drink water and so on, or you can do a dry fasting if you feel okay. So basically it's boost your immune system like really strongly. Some people like do it 1 week, they not eat 1 day, second week 2 days, third week 3 days. I tried, feel quite well, lose a little bit of weight, but it's still fine. You can try it. But even one day, it's pretty much enough for like make your leg acid really aggressive, react on everything around what's really, really important. So now is really a lot of cool videos when people just try to different food and put a blood and microscope and see how it works. So basically, by using the system what I said, you can see how it look like. So now we have a lot of access to the information. And other things, you know, like HP balance in our body depend what we eat and how we active are. And also we have to balance O2 and CO2 in our body. Not many people know. So basically you can do it with breathing techniques. So same, if you feel sick already, you can do it for longer. For prophylactic, you need to do it less. So basically a lot of doctors, they describe a different system. They call it differently. Also it's having yoga and Tibetan gymnastic in a Chinese tradition and all of the same thing, but with the tiny different techniques and as different names. So basically what you need to do is just to hold your breath. If you feel really, really bad, you can take a plastic bag and a few times breathe in and breathe out, but it's not really good because you breathe out the waves. So hold the breath is much easier. So I'll tell you need to work the techniques what you need to do, and you can enhance it by your way. So let's say you inhale during 10 seconds, you hold the breath 10 seconds and you exhale 10 seconds. If you feel fine, try to increase it to 15 seconds. If you feel fine, try to increase it to 20 seconds. So basically it one cycle it will be 1 minute, and you need to do it during 5 minutes at least, like if a prophylactic every day or few days a week. If you feel sick already, you need to do it longer, at least 15 minutes or even longer. And if you this technique is working well for you, you can inhale, let's say 20 seconds, hold it for 30 seconds, breathe out 10 seconds. So basically a lot of different techniques, but they all work absolutely the same, and you can enhance it by yourself. Okay, so I'll just give you an idea, and you can easily find it online. It's really, really a lot of different kind of techniques, especially from yoga, and everyone it's work well. If you want some enhanced one, so you can do, let's say, squats, sit-ups, push-ups, whatever, small run. You just hold your breath and do the push-ups as long as you can, take rest and go again. Efficiently it not works well, but yoga said it is. I don't know, different yoga position where they enhance your immune system, like a different bending position and upside down position would stimulate your organ and your hormone secretion. Same like when you do like short-term fasting, it's increase your hormone level as well. That's like really, really important. About the different kind of supplements, I don't know. A lot of what sell on the market, I wouldn't say it works well. I don't really believe in the medicine, but the herbs have a big variety of different roots, herbs, leaves. It depends where you stay. So in Russia they have a different roots, in China is different. So like, let's say tribulus or ginseng, ginger, garlic, onion. But yeah, you need to eat everything like raw for get a benefits from it. So if you will do everything in general, like sleep enough time, eat good food, drink enough water, it's really important, keep your CO2 balance. So basically for balance your body with a CO2 and O2, it basically what it do same. You can find a video and see how your blood look like under microscope. So all our hemoglobin cells, they stick it after the food, especially with sugar or whatever, like coins and big chains, what not really good, and it's not easy for transfer all of the oxygen ever since. So basically when you balance your CO2 level, they unstick from each other, and your blood will be not so solid. It will be easy to float into all of the body parts and so on. Yeah, be active, and if you keep everything like in general, so you don't need to do like anything just so much special. Little bit of activity, normal food, enough water, fresh air if you can afford it, and that's it. Your immune system will work like super, super cool. So it will be like soldiers with all the equipment and good story about any pandemic or virus or whatever, just keep on the road and then get it set.